Previously on Dream Team.
Charlie, what have I told you about talking to strangers?
He pays for the dragons.
Sorry, we scared you.
Millions of pounds gone down the drain because you stupid girl, couldn't organise a meal properly. Go on, you're fired.
I've had a really great day today and I'd love to see you again.
Let's just see how it goes, OK?
Yes! What a dramatic ending! And Raw Sword provides the knockout punch!
Gary?
Carl Fletcher, we're going to need a sample. And Danny Rawthorn?
I don't want to go. I want to see Danny.
Well, I've told you we can't. Now, come on.
Look, could you get a message to someone for me?
I have to stay here with you.
Yeah, that's why I can't do it.
Listening to Harchester Sound 102.6 FM. And in sports news, the Dragons newly returned from Dublin and their triumph against Shelburne in the UEFA Cup take on Liverpool early next week, followed shortly after by a game against Rushden in the third round of the Worthington Cup.
Hello. Who is this?
How do I know what you say is true? No, I have no comment to make. Okay, just give me half an hour to look into it.
Ring Mill Lane and get a message to Richard Davis Spears. I want him here in 15 minutes. He and Carl Fletcher.
If they ask what it's about?
You don't know. Just warn them both to turn the mobiles off and don't take any calls in the meantime.
Why, she didn't say why? Well, maybe the police have dropped the charges against you. This is our lucky week.
Il sera de retour à quelle heure? Merci, au revoir.
He's at a meeting out of the building, not back till midday.
There must be somebody else at UEFA we can try. No, don't answer that. Tell Zoe to put all my calls through to the press office and ask them to tell any callers we've heard nothing official yet. David, Carl, thanks for coming in at such short notice. I'd like to take this meeting in the boardroom.
Mrs. Block's office. No, I'm afraid she's in a meeting.
But they got it wrong. They must have.
I'm afraid not. UEFA have confirmed it. One out of the two Harchester players that were tested for drugs after the Shelbourne game has failed.
Oh, I see. So as it's drugs, it's got to be me.
Oh, is the Pope a Catholic? What was it, you idiot? Grass? Cocaine?
What happened to innocent till proven guilty?
I said no calls.
It's UEFA. They said you'd want me to interrupt. He's faxed through their official statement.
Oh, my goodness. Fletch, you can go.
What, and that's it? No explanations, no apologies?
I'm sorry for wasting your time. It wasn't Fletch who failed the test. It was Danny Rawson.
Danny Rawson is found guilty of using illegal substances. Bearing in mind that he was the best player on the field of play and scored the winning goal, we would expect UEFA to overturn the result.
Do you want Harchester kicked out of the competition?
That's precisely what I want. Any team that cheats and uses illegal substances has no place in the UEFA Cup.
When can we expect a statement, Dave?
Where's Danny right
now? Shelbourne's appeal.
One of Danny Rawson's two samples failed the test. Till we know the result from the other sample, we don't know for sure that he's done anything wrong. Innocent until proven guilty, remember?
Have you any idea what Danny's been taking? Performance enhancing or the nose candy?
This is start your managerial career yet in mind, Dave.
I don't have anything else to give you right now, so I suggest you pack up and go home.
Hi, Dad.
We've got a big problem. If he's guilty, every deal we've set up for him is dead in the water.
Yeah, if he's guilty. Good morning to you too. Come in.
Where is he? You know his mobile switched off.
He's probably in hiding, poor Danny. Let's just hope those B samples turn out negative.
Poor Danny? Poor us. If he's guilty, he's banned. And we can forget about the boot deals, the magazine covers, TV ads, all of it.
Well, how long might the ban be?
It's down to UEFA. Could be a year.
What could be a year?
The next time we have sex.
Well, it's going, that'll be an improvement.
And the way you're going, that'll be the earliest you can hope for, mate.
Oi, isn't it a bit early for all this? Now, listen, Tash, we need to get him here, out of arm's way, where the press can't reach him.
Now, I'll tell you what, let's advertise in tourist brochures, or just call it a hotel and have done with it.
Jamie, this is the whole of Danny's career we're talking about.
No one knows where the boy is. David Spears was giving nothing away at all. And no comment on Shelbourne's appeal. OK, I'll keep you posted as soon as anything gives.
Oh, he's not answering his mobile.
If that pack of bloodhounds out there finds him before we do, they're going to eat him alive. There's too much riding on this, there's millions.
Well, look, Shelbourne were bound to try and get us kicked out. I mean, we'd do the same. But don't worry, eh? I mean, they haven't got a prayer.
When I hear that from UEFA, I might feel a bit better. Come on, Danny, where are you?
Well, let's face it, Linda. I mean, since when has the B sample contradicted the A? Now, we need to find out from him what he might have taken. And if he's been at the White Lines...
Danny wouldn't do that. I've known him a long time. That's the thing. I just don't understand it at all.
Well, you know what they say. It's always the quiet ones, isn't it?
Danny, they've been looking all over for you. Let me call Mrs. Block.
No, no, don't do that, please. I need you to help me. Now that Nicky isn't here, who would know about the Junior Dragons?
Why?
I need to find someone, but I only know his first name, Charlie, and his mum's called Lisa.
I could look on the computer, but there are over 2,000 kids on this season's list, and it probably doesn't sort by first name.
Please, look, you've got my mobile number. Just call me if you find him.
Danny, you can't go out there. It's crawling with press.
We have the radio.
My alarm clock. The burger's left wet. What are you wearing?
A strippogram outfit. What does it look like? Went out yesterday and got myself a job as a chambermaid at the Grange.
But Nicky, why? You've got proper qualifications.
Well, there are no jobs requiring a BTEC in sports management. I've got to pay the mortgage.
Why don't you ask Mrs. Block or Claudia? I'm sure you can get your job back.
No chance. From now on, Harchester United is a dirty word in this house. Which reminds me, your appearance fee from the Charlton game, hand it over.
What for?
Since you left the keys on the door and you got us burgled, you can start paying for new furniture.
Well, the thing is, they must have taken it as well, because I left it lying on the hall table. They must have took it.
Danny, wait. Running away won't get you anywhere, son. Why run if you got nothing to hide?
I need the absolute truth, you understand? We need to be honest with each other right from the start. Now tell me, have you taken anything?
No, nothing.
Then why is the A sample positive? Danny! Look at me!
Well, apart from a food supplement.
Creatine? No, it can't be that. That's all checked out and kosher. Are you sure you've taken nothing else? Danny, what are you keeping from me?
I took some of Andre's.
You what?
He said it was definitely okay.
What were you doing taking something that we haven't okayed and checked out?
He said everybody else was taking it.
Well, obviously not, you idiot!
housekeeping.
Whereabouts did you meet her?
The bar. She was serving. She was, you know.
You're unbelievable.
Oh, it was incredible.
It's Nikki Peggs from housekeeping. What name do you have for room 207? Oh, because I thought they were supposed to be checking out today. Is it Spence? I had a Claudia Spence down for this room. Claudia Irving? Oh, no, my mistake. Thanks, bye.
It must be a fantastic feeling to think that something bad's happened and you're in the clear for it.
Why don't you go and play a game of cards or something, Jay, yeah?
Seriously, though, Fletcher, did you kill Dittani? Look, we won't tell anyone, just between us.
Yeah. That's well funny, that is.
You all right?
No. Thanks for asking.
How are you, Andre?
Look, the second sample could still be negative, you know, mate.
And any test that Fletch passes has to be pretty flawed, if you ask me.
Yeah, but no one did they?
Chill out, Fletch. Jamie, he make joke.
Oh, you think this is a joke? This is all your fault, you sick...
Yeah, calm down.
Danny! David needs to speak to all of you before we start training today. And of course, we do not take any calls from journalists. Jamie, don't you realize the seriousness of this? If we do not get this story under control, we are out of the UEFA Cup.
I've been through about half so far, but there's a Charlie Gerrard. He's,
9 years old.
Yeah, that's gotta be him. It was his birthday the day of the Shelbourne game. Are his parents listed?
Just his mother, Miss L. Gerrard.
Oh, Claudia, you're a genius. Give me the address.
I really don't know if I should do that. I'll have to call you back.
Where the hell is everyone? Where's Linda? Is this club capable of getting anything
right? Dad, you break our dinner date in Dublin, you don't bother to call me, and then you start yelling at me like I'm some kind of servant.
I said, where's Linda?
I thought you'd left for New York already.
I pass a new stand at Heathrow, only to discover that my club is on the front page of every damn newspaper. Now, what do you expect me to do?
Calm down, for a start.
Calm down!
Listen, you know, the more you rant, the worse you're going to feel about it afterwards, and the more red roses you're going to have to buy for me tomorrow. Claudia, can I have a coffee, please? I presume you know how Mr. Irving likes it.
Danny, who I discover has gone missing again, informs me that you've been supplying him with some magic potion, some dietary supplement, all of your own. Well?
Yeah? So what?
What you mean, besides the fact that you've no business supplying a product we don't know about, it might just be the reason why Danny failed a drugs test. It could cost his club a fortune, him his World Cup place, plus the fact it could put the kibosh on his entire career.
Here, Gaffer. How do you know it's Andre's stuff?
Guys, put me at ease on this. Who else might have taken this stuff? Oh, no, don't. You haven't. Well, all of you! You as well! Oh, I don't believe it! What?
Well, not me, boss. Who's been a lot of naughty boys, then? Eh?
You?
Before you say anything, all right, I am really sorry about Ireland. There was nothing I could do, honestly. Can I come in?
What are you doing here? Charlie's at school.
I came to see you. Please, I'm in so much trouble and I don't know where else to go. This is doing my head in. The minute that B sample comes back, that is it for me. I'm out. Banned. I'll be a national disgrace.
But if it's just a food supplement, why can't you tell people that? I mean, you hear of athletes who took cough syrup who didn't know there was anything wrong with it, and they get let off. It's not like you're meant to cheat.
It doesn't work like that.
Yeah, well, it should. This isn't fair.
I suppose all we can do, really, is just hope the B sample's clear.
Might it be?
I doubt it. No one's going to want to know me. I mean, what's Charlie going to think?
He's too young to understand.
No, he's not. Kids talk. I mean, he thinks I was his, I don't know, sort of hero. And as soon as this hits the fan, I'm dirty. I'm afraid this is going to finish me. But could I mean, I don't want this to sound weird or come out the wrong way, but could I stay here with you and Charlie? I don't mean like that. I just need to be somewhere normal. Do you know what I mean?
How are you?
Stressed, anxious and angry. Yourself?
Snap. Mrs. Block's on the phone.
Well, she might want to get on a plane when I've had a word with her.
OK. Yes, I understand.
Mr. Irving.
OK, right, well, you've got my mobile number. Give us a call if anything changes. Thank you. Well, a ray of sunshine.
Yeah?
That was UEFA. It turns out individual players are responsible for what they put into their own bodies. One player failing a drugs test has no comeback on the club. In other words, Shelbourne can forget trying to bump us out of the UEFA Cup.
Excellent. That's good, yeah.
Why do I sense that you're not as pleased about this as we are, David?
Did they say what the story would be if the entire team were using banned substances?
Tell me you're joking.
Hello, reception? Hi, this is Claudia Spence from Harchester United, Linda Block's office. We're checking your bill for this month, and we need to know which players are in which rooms. Right, thanks very much. Andre Belanov, 206.
Mum, what's for lunch?
Shh.
What is it?
You ready?
What's he doing in our house?
Well, he's in a bit of trouble. Because we're his friends, he's come to talk to us.
But he must have a £1 million house. Why do you want to stay here?
Well, maybe he's got a £1 million house. Not many friends he can trust. Come on, I'll get you lunch.
Is he going to stay for dinner?
Don't know.
Is he going to stay the night?
Charlie? Overpaid, oversexed, talentless, useless waste of £9 million. We can't jump the gun until we've had it tested. Andre's stuff could be perfectly innocent. We'll have to find a lab somewhere.
Are you nuts? Oh, all it takes is one person from the lab to make a phone call to the newspapers, like they did today.
Yeah, you're right. I can just see the headlines now. Entire Dragons first team squad on drugs. We really would be kicked out of Europe.
For starters. Now, we have to keep this completely in-house. Destroy it.
But what if the FAPL decide to do another test after Monday's league game? And what if the stuff is still in their systems? Then we'll have two more failures to worry about, won't we?
Can we get out of the game?
It's live, they won't let us.
I better get the players back in straight away.
Claudia?
Yes?
You've got all the players' mobile numbers. Give them a call. Get them back to Mill Lane ASAP.
Yeah, and tell them to bring every last ounce of Andre's Eastern Delight with them. Ain't nobody.
Whenever I'm down, I call on you, my friend. Two-timing, sex-mad, arrogant.
I mean, what is the big deal? It's widely taken in Eastern Europe. As always, the foreigner is to blame, eh?
I'll grab my box. I'll meet you in the lobby. Okay. Might as well go in my car.
What the hell do you think you're doing? Oh, Nicky. What are you doing all that gear?
I work here now.
Used to work here, mate. Reception.
I'm sorry.
Go on, get me fired. I deserve it. I don't even know what I'm doing here in this job. After I got sacked in Ireland, it wasn't even my fault. I gave it to Claudia to see to and she just forgot it. It's not like she even needs the job.
She's a waste of time, that one.
And when we got back from Ireland, we've been burgled. Gary's weight, the stereo, the TV.
Oh, you're joking. No, Nicky, that's not fair. Look, we like to have a new in charge of stuff. It's the other daft cat I should have got rid of.
Some hope there. It's her dad's club.
You what?
Claudia is Sam Irving's daughter. At least I think so.
Of course. All that designer gear and the Aussie accent. Yeah, we could have some fun here.
Oh, I shouldn't have told you. What are you going to do?
Look, I've got to go back to the club. I want you to hand in your notice and then meet me at the bar at 8. I'm going to buy you the best meal you've ever had. By this time tomorrow, you'll be back at Archer United as team coordinator.
I'm not sure if I even want the job back after the way I've been treated.
Not even if they beg you. And they will beg you when I finish with her.
Ah, Pegsy. My favourite card player in all the world.
What a word were you about that, actually?
Sure you can afford it?
I was wondering. I mean, I'm out of luck, right, all over the place at the moment. And, well...
Today, Pegsy.
You couldn't let me have a bit back, could you?
You what?
Like all of it.
Well, it's not the done thing, Sunshine. Oh,
look, Nicky got fired over the meal mix-up in Ireland, right? We got the flat done the same night. We've lost everything. We're skint. Oh, you're a star.
There's 200 sheets there, that's all I've got.
200 bucks?
Yeah, and for that, I want my car washed, polished and valeted.
Oh, you're having a laugh.
Look, I'm willing to let you earn the money. It's just code of honour, sorry.
Well, let's have a look then. Does it glow?
Yeah, lost, mate. How come you didn't get any of this stuff anyway?
I like to stick to my traditional liquid supplements.
Yeah, and the rest.
Why do they do it to themselves? That's what I always ask myself. When they have the world at their feet.
I've called you both in today because Danny's gone on the missing list again. We're worried about his safety. We're worried about his state of mind.
And you're worried about what he might say to the press, am I right?
There is that to consider, yes. But as his agent, you stand to lose as much as we do. Look, if Danny tells the whole world that he and his teammates have been taking some black market Eastern European food supplement...
Danny won't talk to the press. He wouldn't do that.
And you've got absolutely no idea where he is. Girlfriends, friends...
I know. He asked me to get an address for him, someone at the Junior Dragons Club he met in Ireland.
And when did he do that?
This morning.
You've known where Danny was for half a day, and you didn't think to tell anyone? You...
At least we've found him now. Claudia, can you find the address for me, please? And Tash, you're probably the best person to go and get him.
Yeah.
No. No, let's get him to come in of his own accord. Well, the boy's probably fighting and confused at the moment. Well, to him, we're the enemy, aren't we? And if he gets the impression that we're trying to hunt him down, he could do something really stupid. So let's get Claudia to make the call. No way he doesn't even have to know that we know where he is. Shall we give her some space?
Right.
You've been listening to us try to find him all day and you didn't think to say anything. Oh, hello, brain cell.
He made me promise not to tell anyone.
Oh, you work for Danny Rawsthorne, do you? No, you don't. You work for Harchester United, which means you put the interests of this business, my business, before the interests of some snivelling teenage drug cheat. Do you understand? Now, you make that damn call.
Hello?
Mum, he's awake.
Is he now?
How are you feeling?
Yeah, better. Well, until I remembered. Thank you.
Hello? Yes, this is Lisa Gerrard. Can you hang on a moment, please? Is someone called Claudia Spence?
It's Linda Block's secretary. She helped me find you. Hello, Claudia.
They're going mad here trying to find you, Danny. I could lose my job if Mrs. Block finds out I knew where you'd gone. Why don't you just come in now? They'll be so glad to see you. No one's going to care where you've been or who you've been with. Please, Danny.
The sooner you go back and face them, the better. Would you like me to come with you?
Would you?
Can I come?
You most certainly cannot. Your Aunt Jenny will come and mind you.
Nicola Peggs?
Yeah?
Delivery. Where do you want it?
I don't understand.
There's an envelope attached. Keep your head down and don't say anything. Move!
Lads! He's got nothing to say until the B sample results come through. We'll hold a press conference tomorrow, all right?
Jeff, Mr. Stein! Danny!
Are you all right, Danny?
Yeah, this is Lisa.
Hiya, pleased to meet you.
Hi.
That was close.
Jeff Stein, Danny's agent. My daughter, Natasha, handles his PR.
Lisa Gerrard.
Didn't know you were seeing anyone.
I'm just a friend.
David wants to see you at the training ground. Better go round the back.
Will you wait for me?
I'll look after her, babe.
Good girl.
If you're going out with Golden Boy, you've got to expect him to want pictures. Let me organise it, and I can make you a couple of grand.
I don't think so.
Right. I'm guessing there's nandrolone in that powder and that stuff stays in the system for 10 days minimum. So, hands up. Who's had any in the last 10 days? Which means if the Premier League hold another drugs test after Monday night's game, two more of you are going to fail. I mean, at this rate, we'll be lucky if they let us in the Central League, never mind Europe. Right, this is what we're going to do. I want every last drop of that stuff down the toilets now.
Oh, that is a complete waste of money.
What, you or it?
All right, cut it out now.
I gave it to everybody else to help them.
But he didn't know the stuff was dodgy.
I don't give a monkey's what he knows.
There's nothing wrong with it. I swear it on my mother's life.
Well, if there's nothing wrong with it, then why did I fail the test? Tell me that.
Maybe you're lying.
Sorry, what?
Maybe you take something else and you blame it on my drug.
Come on, man!
Both of you, Pexy, collect all those boxes, flush them down the toilet now. Andre, Mrs. Block wants to see you. Go on. And the rest of you can clear off. And if I find out that any of you have breathed a word of this to anyone, I will have you transferred out of this club so quick your feet won't touch the ground. Now go on. All right, I know it's hard, it's unfair, and the weight of it's falling on your shoulders, but you've got to try and keep calm.
Keep calm? If I get banned, I won't be able to play in any World Cup.
Look, it may not come to that.
I will be the walking, talking shame of British football. Davids, De Boer, they're already international names, and I'll never get that chance because of him.
Hello? Yeah, he's with me now. Yeah, we'll be right over. All right, the B sample test results are on their way. We need it in the boardroom. Look, listen, lad, whatever happens, you'll be all right. We'll look after you. Now, come on.
The devil. Dear Mrs. Block, we write to inform you that our tests on the B sample taken from Daniel Rawson have proved inconclusive. Due to a contamination of the sample, UEFA will be taking no further action in this matter.
Claudia, would you pour the drinks, please?
Isn't this great news?
I don't really understand. What does this mean?
They can't take action against a player unless both samples show up positive. Now, something went wrong with the second sample they took from Danny, so they didn't get the result.
So we don't really know one way or the other.
The important thing is, young lady, your boyfriend can still play football.
Let's hope you may have missed your last flight to New York.
Yeah, they'll hold it. Is football always this manic?
Afraid so.
It's like a roller coaster, isn't it? I can see now why you get hooked. Speaking of which, let's hope that's the last we hear of drug troubles at Harchester.
And the last we hear of drug testing at Harchester for a couple of weeks at least.
Yeah. Seeing me through to the second round of this UEFA Cup thingy, and we didn't actually get to go to Dublin, I was wondering if you'd do me the honour of accompanying me to the next game. Come on, I'll hire a couple of suites in the best hotel in town, whichever town that happens to be.
Do you know how cold it is in Glasgow at the moment?
And do you know that with your company it'll seem like the Bahamas? With bagpipes. But seriously, thanks for today, Linda. You handled things magnificently.
Yeah, until the next time you want to shout at me.
Hey, listen, take care, kiddo. I'll give you a call, all right?
Can't you at least stay for dinner?
Oh, I can't. Sorry, sweetheart.
Andre's still waiting in your office.
Oh, right.
David Spey, he tell me you want to see me. 2 hours ago.
You'll be relieved to know that Danny's B sample was inconclusive and UEFA won't be taking things any further.
So I can go now and this stupid business is...
Sit down. How long have you been doling this compound out, Andre?
1 month, 2 months, I don't know. Guy I played with years ago, Alexei, he played in Russia. He says it's new thing. All players there, they use it. Better at maintaining energy levels than this rubbish you use here.
This rubbish we use here are supplements that are legal and safe. Yours wasn't. Now, you risked your teammates' health, their careers, never mind their reputations, Andre. And we still won't know whether we're in the clear for another week at least. How could you have been so dumb? I'm fining you the maximum, 2 weeks' wages, and if you pull another stroke like this, I will transfer you to Atom and Gully. Is that clear?
I got now.
I'll bottle this one, please.
Sure.
Tell me. You scrub up well, girl.
Well, the shoes don't really go, but they're the only ones I've got left.
What, the burglars take your shoes?
Afraid so.
Weirdos. How did this lot take you leaving?
Not brilliantly. Staffing crisis, apparently.
Well, maybe if they pay some decent wages, people might want to work here. All right. The next stage of my cunning plan involves Miss Irvin and you getting your job back.
Stevie, why are you doing this?
Because I'm a believer in justice.
Who for, me or you?
The common people. Remember, I ain't always been a footballer. I know what it's like not to have any money.
Of course, it has nothing to do with you getting revenge on Claudia. For her interfering with your fiancés.
They were never my fiancés.
So why'd they both have engagement rings then?
Look, they're a couple of daft tarts who just got carried away, that's all.
Ooh. Just an ordinary working boy, eh? Drinks champagne, runs around in a sports car and is a battle Riley.
Someone's got to do it.
I'm really glad everything went well for you today.
Thank you. I'm sorry about all that stuff back at the club.
It's okay. I should be going in.
I wish...
What?
Well, if I wasn't who I am... This would be easier. I don't want to mess up your life, but I really want to keep seeing you. I know you probably don't want it, what with Charlie and all. I would invite you back to mine, but I wouldn't want to put you through it with the photographers and that.
It's okay. You can come in. Charlie's at my sister's tonight. His cousin's around there.
Well, that's lucky.
Isn't it?
Like champagne.
Tomorrow's Sunday, and you can have a lion.
I can, in my lovely big bed.
Yeah?
Yep, all to myself so I can spread out.
Spread out? Sounds lovely.
It will be.
And then back to work on Monday. Talking of which, Vicky's just walked in.
Stevie, don't.
Better to do it now. She can't make a scene. And then I'll drive you on.
Stevie, I've had a hell of a day and I'm just hoping to have a quiet meal.
Vicky's had a bad day too. Do you know what she's been doing? She's been cleaning your toilet and making your bed. Since she lost her job as a result of your screw-up in Ireland, she's been working as a chambermaid in this hotel on minimum wage.
I'm really sorry, Nikki. I tried to tell David, but with the game and
everything... The game was 2 days ago. And unlike you, Nikki has to work. Because unlike you, she hasn't got a rich daddy who owns a club,
who can bail her out all the time.
How did you find out?
I have my sources. And unless you want the whole of Harchester to know, you'll do exactly as I say.
You don't frighten me.
No? Just think how hard it'll be. All the people you've been working with find out you've been lying to them. Think how differently you're going to get treated once they find out who you really are.
What do you want?
Fair play. Nothing more and nothing less. I want you down that training ground first thing tomorrow morning. I want you to walk into the changing room in front of everybody and say that I, Claudia, am entirely responsible for last week's mess up in Ireland, and I apologise with all my heart to Nikki Peggs for any pain I might have caused her.
As a drug cheat escaped justice was the goal that put Harchester United into the second round of the UEFA Cup, powered by chemicals.
We'll have to make some kind of statement. It's the only way to put a lid on all this speculation. I'll get the press office to call a conference.
I'll call Danny.
No.
Don't want him involved.
But he's involved.
Yeah, but we can't risk having him there, Tash. I mean, all he'd be concerned about is clearing his own name, understandably. And he can only do that by explaining what really happened.
Which shall implicate the other players. We've got other clients here, Tash, including my thick son-in-law, your husband, who also took the stuff. We have to help Linda contain this.
Well, I'm going to get down to training. We're not out of the woods yet. And in the meantime, I want to try and keep things as normal as possible.
Ring down to the press office, get Craig to come up at once.
Linda, I need an extra hour off around lunchtime.
When we're this busy, what for?
Please, I wouldn't ask if it wasn't important.
I suppose so. Be quick as you can, though, yeah?
How can they say these things about you?
You know, every morning for the past 9 months, my phone's rung. First thing, Jeff or Tash, offering me PAs and sponsorship deals, photo shoots, even offers from other clubs. This morning, nothing. I'm dirty. I was so stupid to think that it was all over last night. This will never be over.
This is so unfair. You should speak out. Tell your side of the story.
What's the point?
Because you have done nothing different from the rest of the club. But it's you who's getting all the grief.
Well, you think I should talk to the press?
You've got to do what's best for you. Look, it's none of my business, but you have done nothing wrong. Maybe you should let people know that.
Well, there is this one journo hanking, but he's a bit dodgy.
Aren't they all?
Yeah, maybe. Well, look, I've got to go to training. I know you probably don't want to see me again, too much hassle, but I just want you to know that it's never been like that for me before.
It was special. I don't know what we should do now, Danny. I've got to think of what's best for Charlie as well as myself.
Hey, I know.
But you are so not the person they're writing about.
Where have you been? Come on, lads, let's concentrate. We got Liverpool on Monday night and we got the Worthington Cup a couple of days after that. Now, we won't know for sure how much of Andre's stuff is still in your systems for a couple of days yet, but I don't want any excuses. I want to see you play the best possible football you can. All right? What?
Excuse me. There's something I need to say to you. All of you.
Now?
Yes, now. I have an apology to make. I nearly cost you the Shelburne game.
What? So it wasn't Andre's special brew after all, then?
I'm not talking about the drug thing. It was me that cocked up the meal arrangements that made you all late for the game, and I'm sorry.
Do we really need to hear this now? Shelbourne was yesterday's game. It's gone, forgotten.
Not by Nikki Peggs, it isn't. You sacked her without giving her a chance to tell her side of the story. That goes against this company's official disciplinary procedure. I checked. Nikki's been with the club over a year, you know, which means she can take you to an industrial tribunal for unfair dismissal, if she feels like it. Think of the bad publicity that would cause.
All right, that's enough. Will you go now, please?
Give her job back, please, Mr. Spears. She's terrific at it, really efficient, and she cares. You know you won't find anybody better.
I'll talk to her. Come on, lads. A round of applause to the lady. That was a seriously brave thing to do.
Hello, sports desk. Can you put me through to Paul Hankin, please? It's Danny Rostow. No, I'm not joking. Yeah, I'll wait. Hello, Paul, it's Danny. Look, I was wondering if you'd like to hear my side of this drug story. Well, now, I suppose. Yeah, all right, I'll meet you there in half an hour.
I hope you don't mind me tracking you down like this, but I've got the statement that the club's going to be making in this morning's press conference. Thought Danny would want to see it.
Well, he's not here. He's gone to training, then he's got a meeting.
Really? Who with?
I think he said Rankin, a journalist, something about doing an interview.
Rankin? Oh, my God. What's he doing that for?
I don't know. I think he just wants to put his side of the story across.
That's not how it works in football. If he does that interview, he's not going to save his reputation. He's going to ruin it. You've got to stop him.
Why me?
Because right now you seem to be the only person that can get through to him. Look, trust me on this, Lisa. I know the game, you don't.
Hello, Danny.
Who's there? Oh, she's finally remembered that I exist, has she? Was she what? Oh, right, I'm on my way. Ah! What the hell do you think you're playing at, trying to use her against me?
Danny, listen, no one's trying to use anybody. I just think you'd be making a big mistake if you talk to Hankin.
Oh, do you?
Yes, you're just going to make things worse. Now, I've got the club statement. Look, it exonerates you.
Harchester United takes every precaution to oversee what dietary or vitamin supplements players take. As a club, we condemn utterly the use of performance-enhancing drugs. This is what Linda's going to say? Well, I tell you what, why doesn't she just take out a three-page ad saying the boy's guilty and be done with it?
She also says, we have known Danny Rawsthorne since he came to this club as a schoolboy. We have every faith in his integrity. Be realistic, Danny. She has to stay quiet about the truth or it'll be a disaster for the club. If you support Harchester, then they will owe you big time.
I don't care. I just want to clear my name. I don't want to be some cheat who just got lucky.
Well, there's only one way to stop that kind of talk.
How?
The same way David Beckham shuts up his critics, by taking it on the chin and playing the best football of his career. If you do that interview, then you're just confirming that you were a cheat.
What?
You did take Andre's powder. And do you know what's going to happen when this little confession comes out?
No.
No. Well, you could well get banned after all. This one interview could do 100 times more damage than any mucky test result.
Please, don't ask me what I think, Danny. This is a world I know nothing about. It has to be your decision.
Well, could you at least drive me to training? I really don't feel like driving at the moment.
Be my pleasure. Can't wait to show off my car. Gary Peggs was up till gone midnight last night, polishing it and waxing it. God knows why. Come on.
Hiya, lads. Am I seeing things? Danny Rawsthorne back from the grave?
You're a lucky boy, aren't you?
So we're friends again, yeah? No.
Well, to be fair, mate, he never actually liked in the first place, did he? Eh?
All right, boys, come on, back to work. It's going to be out for a while. You're going to get some stick at away games, but you'll be all right.
All right, lads, come on, back to business. Is it in you?
This club oversees all the dietary and vitamin supplements that our players use officially, but we cannot control what the player chooses to do by himself. Now, we have Danny Rawsthorne's word that he didn't take anything illegal. And for those that have known him since he signed here as a schoolboy, that's good enough. Let's put this incident behind us now and concentrate on something a little bit more important, that's football. Maybe in 6 months' time, Danny will be bringing the UEFA Cup back home to Harchester United. That's all. Thank you.
Coming soon on Dream Team.
I was beginning to think you weren't coming home.
What do you want?
I'll party with you, Andre, if you still want to.
Turn it down, will ya? Scott, stop! Turn it off! Turn it off!
Crazy!